Ladies and gentlemen, there should never be a day that goes by when we don't honor our veterans who fought and are still fighting for our great country. Let's bring the house down with a round of applause for every veteran here with us tonight and around the world. And now, to honor America with the singing of our national anthem, let us welcome 14-year-old, 8th grade student from Manassas, Pennsylvania, Haley Howland.
He's wearing his Made in America red, white, and blue trunks.
His official wedding was 148 pounds. This former United States Army sergeant, who was an amateur, captured the All Armed Forces Championship for 2010 and 11. He also was the National Police Athletic League champion. His professional record is unblemished at 7 wins. He has no defeats, with 5 of those victories coming by way of knockout. He hails from the city of Greyhounds in the Nelson, Pennsylvania. He is Cuban Mexican.
gonna stop him.
Yeah!
Oh! Knuckles.
Also for a spectacular night of boxing presented by Team Bassbridge Promotions. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the judges' scorecards for the decisions. All three judges scored the fight 60-51, and the winner by unanimous decision.
He was fucking on the run. He wasn't trying to fight.
Yeah, my hands hurt, dude. I swear, both of my hands, they felt like they were broke. I couldn't hit him. I tried to hit him in the body, but he was blocking him good at worst. If I go to the body, he was coming over with the overhand left, and I couldn't get back fast enough to block it. So that's why I was like edgy to throw him.
He wasn't trying to win, though. He wasn't trying to beat him. He's just trying to run around.
Yeah. Don't worry,
bro. You look great, man. You all right?
They both hurt. His fucking head was so hard, dude.
Yeah.
You're joking.
I couldn't even punch my head anymore.
I was like, the first round you threw that overhand left, I was like, woo! You missed him by that fucking much. You start touching the body, every time you touch him,
he was down. Yeah.
I want that liver, son.
I was trying to do it.
He was just taking to go.
I want that ankle.
I needed that, though.
Don't worry about that.
Yeah, you needed that. That's all for you, bro.
You needed that. Swollen. Don't listen. It's going to happen.
Put that thing in ice, Sam.
Oh, yeah.
That's it.
Easy. Hey, bro. Well, it feels six rounds.
It feels good. That's what I wanted. You know what I mean? I wanted to go six rounds. I mean, I wanted to stop him, of course, but you know, you want that durability, you know, a little bit just to see what it's like. But I could have got him out of there if his head wasn't so hard. I mean, I hurt both of my hands, man. I was like, wow, like, I never had one.
I mean, it looked like the first couple rounds you were just trying to get some work in. You were almost carrying him a little bit, you know, because you didn't want to go real fast.
Well, I wanted to pace myself. I knew he was tough. I knew he would last long. I mean, so I wanted to pace myself a little bit and box. You know what I mean? I didn't want to just go out there and try to knock him out. You know, I wanted it to come. You know what I mean? And it would have came. Thank you. It would have came, but, you know, I just couldn't hit him in the head anymore. I just couldn't. I couldn't set up for the body. You know what I mean? I tried.
When did your hand start hurting?
After the second round. After the second round, it was my jab because I kept jabbing him, you know what I mean? And then he just kept putting his head down, boom, boom, every time, you know, he would take it. And it would hurt my knuckles. I'm like,
yeah, I mean, you were just stalking.
Yeah. You know, and then after that, I was just like, you know, all right, I'm going to start using my left hand. You know what I mean? Then I started using my left hand. He, you know, his big head would just take it. I'm like, dude, I got to try hitting this kid in the body. But I couldn't go straight for the body because he'd come with the overhand left and end up, you know, catching me a little bit. So then I was like, okay, so I got to try to, you know, work on something here to try to fake him out a little bit, to, you know, move a little bit, try to just do different things. But he was tough, man. I mean, he was definitely tough. It was worth it. I liked him, man. It was a good fight.
I mean, he was a journeyman. He had a lot of losses, but he had a lot of decisions. I mean, you know, he was a tough guy to knock.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
I mean, that was a good fight for you.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was real. I mean, that's what I wanted. This is my sixth round. I'll probably go to eight now, so.
Do you have any idea when you may fight again? Or?
Hopefully next month, you know what I mean? But we'll see, you know, what happens, you know, with my hands and stuff like that, and then, you know, go from there.
I mean, you don't think it's broken?
No, I don't think it's broken. It's just sore, you know what I mean? So you can't train. I got to take, you know, like, you know, a week off, but I mean, I can shadow box and stuff like that. I can always do something. You know what I mean? I just can't hit the bag and stuff like that. I just take it easy, let my hands rest and my body, and then I'll get back to it, you know, go back to the drawing board and see what's going on next.
First time you're a little sore?
No, I'm not really sore.
Your hands?
Oh, my hands are sore, yeah. Yeah, but I knew what I was doing. I wanted to shoulder roll a little bit. I wanted to try the different things, you know, and he was the perfect guy to do that. You know what I mean? He was, you know, he wasn't real skillful, but he had, you know, some, he was there, you know, so it was easy to work on things and see what I was able to do, what I wasn't, you know, try to open him up a little bit. And, you know, I learned a lot today, you know what I mean, to see what, you know, pacing myself and opening up shots. And it was a learning experience. Every fight's a learning experience. You always learn something. So I'll go back and watch the video and you know, we'll see what happens. Thank you.
Hey, Bob. Real quick, just sorry right there. Good job, buddy. Good job. Sorry, man.
No, you're right. Good
side right there.
One more ice here. What's going on,
man? That's your bat.
Thanks, man.
I'll see you next week.
Good fight. I'll see you next week.
Thank you. All right. Take care, brother.
All right, Bob. Take care, bud. I'll take care of you.
You walk out.
Get that chair. Yeah, if you got that chair for me.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Airs 8 o'clock tomorrow. I'll call you.
8 o'clock tomorrow?
Yeah.
Where?
I'll call you.
Okay.
All right.
Free drinks or what?
What's up, man?
What's up, Uncle Lou?
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
What's going on, man?
Hey, man.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it, bro.
I love you, man.
I love you too,
my boy, Bobby.
Thanks for coming, man.
My boy.
What's up, bro?
Nice to meet you, man.
Hey, man, what's going on, man? Thanks for coming, man. I appreciate it, bro.
No, he wants to you sign this shit. I'm like, all right, let me
get it. Give me a minute. I'm going to go out there and sign everything for everybody. So.